Paris, we're in position. Where are we headed?
Your destination lies deep within the fortress, Guardian, in the apothecary wing. There you should find a particular shard of crystal. You might recognize it from Savathun's time in the custody of the Awoken.
So this crystal is a piece of her former prison, which means it was likely on her when she stole the light.
Yes. My source believes the events leading to her escape are intrinsically linked to the mystery before us now. This crystal could very well be the clue we've been looking for.
That must be the apothecary wing. All the way over there.
Yes. Savathun's halls are just as winding and deceitful as her mind. To move forward, you must seek out the more aberrant paths.
Paris, what's the situation?
The Guardian is en route to the object in question now, Commander.
Good. You are sure this will get us the answers we need? We can't afford another dead end.
The Queen of the Reef does not share information lightly.
Mara Sov gave you the tip? You didn't mention that before.
I did, in fact, mention it. To Ikora, moments before you interrupted us. She agreed there was no more reliable source on this matter than Savathun's former captor.
I trust Mara, but she plays her cards too close to her chest. If she had shared this earlier, we wouldn't be so desperate now.
To win against the Hive God of cunning and lies, it's best not to show one's hand too early.
I bet this hive sword will be just as useful as the last one. Now we need to find a lock to smash open.
Thank you.
The Witch Queen may have recast her realm in a lucent sheen, but remnants of dark architecture still lurk underneath.
And the Guardian's new ability reveals these hidden remnants. Yes, Ikora explained. Why can't we use the light to achieve the same result?
The light may be a powerful force, but when dealing in illusions, it has proven insufficient. It is the mind that must bend to see the truths hidden here. Thus, only darkness can show the way.
My only fear is where that way will lead us in the end.
Alright, Guardian, let's focus. To find the way forward, we need a sword and something to smash with it.
You've done well honing the gift granted to you by the Black Fleet, Guardian. Do you see now, Commander, why Ikora chose as she did? For all her doubts, she knew only darkness, channeled by a strong mind, could bring us this far.
I understand. My issue isn't with the call Ikora made, but the fact that she made it on her own. We know how Savathun operates. She singles people out for a reason. There's no need to make her job any easier. And Eris, I think you know better than anyone that darkness is not a path to be forged alone.
She wasn't alone. No, I take your point.
I
This is definitely the apothecary wing. Somehow, it feels even creepier in here.
Naturally. You're trespassing on the testing grounds for the Lucent Hive's most wretched experiments. Savathun likely appointed one of her High Council wizards to keep watch over this place. Find them. The crystal is sure to be nearby.
Signs of a crystal so far. Just rows and rows of jars filled with... Is that light? But it's tainted somehow.
Savathun has always encouraged her wizards to push boundaries of hive magic. It seems that hasn't changed with the light. Proof, perhaps, that corruption has far less to do with the power than the one channeling it.
Or the power has permanent side effects. Darkness transformed Savathun and her kin from prey to predators.
Not darkness itself, but an entity behind it corrupted the Hive. Conditioned their power on an endless blood tithe. Their fate is not inevitable.
I have no doubt that some can handle darkness with discipline. But those who can't, they're not the only ones to pay the price.
Thank you.